Hello, let us study TTL gates today. Okay, the first gate is TTL NOT gate. This is the circuit for the TTL NOT gate. A TTL NOT gate performs this operation of inversion. If the input is 0, the output is 1. And if the input is 1, the output is 0. Logic 0 corresponds to a low voltage. If I'm talking about TTL, low voltage would be 0 volt and high voltage would be 5 volts, right? So in this manner, we expect the operation of the TTL NOT gate. Let us look at the circuit once more. The input is applied at this end and the output is obtained here. You have four BJT transistors and they are all NPN transistors, NPN as the arrow indicates. The input is applied at the emitter of Q1 transistor. This would be the base and this would be the collector. Okay. From here, input applied here would be, let us call it a logic 0. Logic 0 means 0 volt. So this is a low voltage. What is the voltage available at the base here? The voltage is applied here is VCC. Let the voltage drop across the R1 transistor be VR1. Then the voltage at this point would be VCC minus VR1, as you can well see. So this voltage is VCC minus VR1. VCC minus VR1 is a positive voltage with respect to 0 volt. VCC minus VR1 is a positive voltage applied at the peak and 0 volt is a low voltage or a relatively negative voltage applied at the end. So P gets a positive voltage and N gets a negative voltage, which means that it is a forward biased junction. Okay. Now, if this is a forward biased junction, the current will prefer to follow this path. Collector base junction, that is this junction, is reverse biased because this is a higher voltage and this is also high voltage. So this is reverse biased. Therefore, no current will flow through this path. Obviously, the current will always follow the low resistance path, which is the emitter base junction. The emitter base junction being forward biased, it is the low resistance path and current will follow this path. Therefore, current will not flow through the other path, or the very little current will flow. That current will not be sufficient enough to turn on Q2, which means Q2 will be off. Now, if Q2 is off, the current that flows from VCC, this is the positive voltage, positive supply voltage VCC, the current that is flowing from the positive voltage will, it sees that there is a block here that because Q2 is off, it acts as an open switch. So the current will prefer to flow into the base of Q3, turning Q3 on. Now, if Q2 is off, meanwhile, there is no current flowing into the base of Q4 because no current is allowed to flow through Q2. Therefore, Q4 is also off. If Q3 is on and Q4 is off, there is a path like this, which means current flows from VCC to the output, pulling up the output to VCC. That means logic 1. What just happened right now? You input a 0 and you got 1 as output. Isn't that what our NOT gate does exactly? Input 0, output 1. Case solved.